it ain't.
Dirty old Bill's Carphonics here, eh?
Freaking right it is, boys. We're going to go over, and we got some parts there. We might put a little stereo action in the old Silverado here.
A little Silverado?
Freaking right we will.
Silverado action.
See what we can't bust or blow up, eh, bud?
Yeah, why wouldn't we?
What are you doing, buddy?
I'm taking out your radio, bud.
Yeah.
I'm thieving it.
I said I was going to show you me put the head unit in, but I've got more experience here now. So guess what, boys and girls? We're going to watch, hey, for a minute here. Why wouldn't we?
Yeah, you'll see once we take out the radio out of the hole here how little room there is behind it.
I gotcha.
They create like a little cavity back there. You just got to trim it out and then we can throw the module back in behind the radio.
Perfect.
You know, if we want to get the antenna for the navigation, we should probably take these out too.
Yep, definitely. I'll pull that one because it's easier.
That one's a 10 mil over there.
Yeah.
This one's a 7 mil, should I say?
Maybe.
This one's a 7 mil. Those are 10s.
Yeah, there's only one on that side, so we'll probably go that way, eh?
Yeah. Well, yeah, but this whole thing will pop off.
Oh, it does?
The whole thing comes right off.
Oh,
decent.
Take out both of the A-pillars.
Okay.
Yeah,
so that way we can put the wire in a nice spot where it's not catching your feets.
Yeah.
I don't like feetsy-catsies.
No. This just folds down ever so nicely, and the radio pops out of the hole here, but you see?
Gotcha, so you just gotta...
Yeah, just like a little... And then you have tons of room back there.
Oh, right on, yeah. Why would they even put that there, bud?
Ah, just so, you know, it has a place for the fact, you know, little nubs here, little nipple.
Oh, so it holds it back the radio from going...
behind here. Oh, yeah, I guess, you know. Look at this thing, this old school GM LAN radio.
She's a beauty, eh?
Yeah, it's not I'll bad put... shape considering. I mean, usually all the buttons will have like, you know, they'll be worn off, you know, where you're seeking left and right. And this guy obviously had ginger fingers. You know
little,
what I mean?
Little touchy touchy.
A little touchy. He didn't have to go, you know, back and forth and
like that.
Yeah.
And wear off all the markings. Ginger fingers.
So anyways, boys, there you go. There's not much to pull them out. I'll put that one in the box in case I sell the old rig, even though I probably won't ever take out this Kenwood head unit ever again because it is like mini, but it's like brand new, isn't it?
Oh, it is, yeah. We should be using a plastic pry tool. One time I took a radio out, this stupid little cap right here. It was a lady's truck, and she had all sorts of crap in the back seat. And I popped this thing off. You guys just saw it kind of flung out at you, and it went... back there, and I never found it. I had to order one of these stupid little plugs from the GM dealership because I could never find it back.
It just
disappeared in the back of the truck.
For frig's sakes.
$8, this stupid thing, and like 7 weeks to wait for it. So there's that, and there's a 7 mil underneath it here, boys.
A little doodad 7 millage.
Little 7 milli.
How do you like my floor lights, bud, I put in?
Oh, those are pretty decent.
Yeah.
Those are pretty decent. Those aren't factory.
They even dim.
You'll notice this is shorter than the rest of them.
We'll just keep adding to the collection.
A little bit of the pullback action here. And the good thing about taking off these A-trim panels too is that when you get the Bluetooth mic in here, you just run it down the A-pillar down here and then behind the head unit. Instead of having to go down and then around and up again.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, because there's really no way of getting back behind here to run it up and behind, but it's nice when this panel's off.
Oh, I liked your idea. I didn't know you could do that. And that's something that I learned today, boys and girls, peoples.
These little things just pull off ever so nicely here.
The tweeters are probably dickered.
But hey, we're going to use them anyways.
Why wouldn't we?
I just had that off, bud.
Oh, did you?
Yeah, see my loom there?
Oh, what's that for?
That's for these lights under here, bud.
Oh, you know, we ran them off the dome lights.
I tried to connect from the wires going up and no go. It just kept throwing an error.
It wouldn't come on.
And then I got YouTube in it. Hey.
YouTube, boys.
They said you got to hook it up the dome light. And that doesn't even make sense to me.
AC Delco, freaking built-in capacitor there. A little built-in cap.
Decent.
Gets rid of the base.
That one's got to go, bud.
Yeah, we got to put some Morels or Focals in there, eh?
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
That's down the road, boys.
Down the road.
Down the road. We just got to get a head unit in for now. We do, so I have my old Bluetooth Aruski.
There's that. And then once we get that panel off, these little trims will come off here and there. Those are 10 millis.
Just had that off yesterday, bud.
Yeah, yeah.
Can I put the old Dash Aruski
Dash
cam.
This whole panel just lifts up like so.
Oh.
Would you look at that, eh?
We might not need that off, bud.
Yeah, you have to in order to get the panel all the way off. You have no choice.
Oh, it hooks under.
It hooks under, yeah.
Gotcha.
We don't really necessarily need to take that one off, but it's just nicer so you don't have to.
It's out of the way.
Because reality is that once you get that GPS antenna in there, you can mount it underneath this panel. You don't even have to have it visible.
It doesn't have to be.
Oh, I might make it visible. Is that okay, though?
Oh, you can.
Decent.
I just like to hide them. You know what I mean? OEM style. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I didn't know they could catch signaling or something.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. It uses, I mean, as long as it's up by the windscreen, you know, somewhere real copacetic like. But now, see, once this panel's off, look at, you can see the light back behind
here. Yeah, just cut that out and away you go.
All sorts of room back there.
Decent.
To put the modules and stuff that we are not hanging out everywhere, eh?
Friggin' right.
I'll be back, boys. I'm going to go in and get a 10 mil, and Gatlin's going to talk to you for a minute.
Yeah.
Why wouldn't he? We'll get this thing installed here, boys. We got a pack harness here. So this module is an OS5, does GM LAN 29. There's all sorts of different GM insignias there for different models and make, but this one's a GM LAN 29. And I got the factory plugs here, so these plugs will plug directly into our factory plugs right here. And this will give us our door chimes, it'll give us reverse trigger. He doesn't have factory satellite radio, so we won't be using that harness on there. Here's our little door dinger here. This one also retains steering wheel controls if you want to do steering wheel controls, but he doesn't have steering wheel controls. He has just cruise, which is a separate identity, so you won't have to worry about that too much.
Yeah.
So once we get out this dash, cut this dash out right there, as you guys were seeing there, we'll be able to, you know, get this module up underneath there and nice and clean, and it'll just be, you know, kind of looking like that there instead, right? So it'll be pretty nice. I think Billy has now got his 10 milli. No 10 millis on a drilly here, boys. All doing things by hand.
Oh, yeah, man. So I think we should start this truck because I'm colder than dicks.
Oh, you're colder than dicks.
Holy frig.
Got a little bit of shrinkage going on, do you?
Oh, that doesn't have to be cool for that.
Okay, well, we'll just take our climate controls here, boys, and just crank that heat up, shouldn't we? There we go.
Here we go. Now you'll be able to hear everything.
Yeah, yeah.
Like a little blower in the air hole.
Yeah, a little blower in the air hole.
Oh, careful.
Careful. All the screws in one place there, boys.
Brought some candies along for the ride here.
Oh, did you show him the harness?
I did show him the harness.
That thing is killer, bud.
It's huge.
It's huge.
That's what she said.
Massive harness.
A little bit overkill. This is the only one that I had in stock currently that would make it work. So
overkill's good for the old dirty old Bilson.
Yeah.
Don't forget to subscribe and like too, and hit that notification bell bar button if you like this stuff. And don't forget to go and check out old Gatlin's channel there. I'll put it in the link below. I will.
Check out Carphonics if you guys want to see my review video of Bilson's golf cart there. I'll grab your coffee
it's
there,
coming
Billy.
Up. It's coming up,
yeah,
eh?
It's coming up. I'll be doing a review video of Billy's golf cart there. Got a real sweet stereo installed on it. So yeah, now that panel comes off, will be one plug for the automatic lights there in the center there, if you guys see that right there. So when Billy pulls the panel up, he'll have to disconnect that there and then it'll just pull up. Nothing get to it.
He's got a little doodad.
You can just pull on her?
Scared.
Come on, you son of a bitch.
Great one, you don't want to do that.
Oh, which one am I pulling then? Here, let's watch a professional do it because I'm just going to cock it over.
Oh my God, Billy. Ah,
decent.
Decent. Cotter, a little drippage, it's all right, bud.
Oh my God.
Don't worry about it.
Oh my fault, boys. Oh, there you go. Oh, the whole little knobby comes out.
That's what I meant.
Gotcha.
That's what I meant.
All right.
I was trying to unplug it.
Lots of parts, boys.
Got all the room in the world now to work, eh?
Oh, yeah, man.
So,
decent.
Guess what?
Yeah, we're just waiting for old Steve there to get the old Ford fired up, as you can see.
Yeah.
Once we get that fired up,
we're going to start pre-wiring this up.
Oh, are we?
Yeah,
wait. You want to do that? Okay.
Yeah. We'll get her all ready to go and make her real nice and copacetic.
All right.
Pre-wiring. Got any rags or anything before this stuff dries?
Oh, yeah, bud.
We should have brought some of that Dynamat. Unless Stevie Boy has a couple little nubs.
I don't know where it went.
Oh,
well. I had a whole box of Kleenex in here, bud, and it's gone. So you know what happened there, eh? The women stole it.
Cleaning.
Well, I was going to pre-wire this, but Gatlin just loves this stuff, and he wants to do it. He does. Don't you, bud?
No, I fucking certainly do, buddy.
I'll just put this up here, and we'll fast-forward it.
Throw her in and we'll be good to go, boys.
Well, we're here. We're going to give the old Ford F-350 a cold start, boys. The old diesel, eh? See if we can't get her to fire. She hasn't been, but she's got a bad injection. She hasn't been running in 6 months.
Listen to her, boys. She's trying.
Decent.
The old rattle box, eh?
Thank you. finally start to swirl up and whistle.
Stevie's gonna fire up the old Fox body, boys.
Hey, we got two of them in here, we do, don't we, Steve? What's in this one, Steve?
347.
347, boys.
Done, right? She's got what?
Dirt block, AFR heads, solid roller cam. She's ready for turbos.
She's ready for turbos, boys. That one there's got a stroker 383, boys. She goes, she does. She's got line lock and everything. That one's strip.
Strip ready it is.
Listen to the lump on her, boys.
Hey.
Hey.
Fox bodies are awesome. Especially ones that sound like that. I'm gonna shut this for a minute, bud.
Jeez.
Almost forgot about you, boys, just so you know. You gotta pull that piece out right there, you do.
You don't have to if you're doing a singleton radio.
Yeah,
but if you're doing a radio like yours with all the accessories, then it's just a little nicer to cut that square out so you can throw all the modules back in behind.
Look at the room back there, eh, buddy?
Yep.
Holy.
Well, boys and girls, peoples, I'm back. We're back from the old stereo installation. She's in, and she's working mint. Friggin' right it's working mint, boys. So I got a bunch of clips from tonight and this and that and the other thing, and thanks a lot, Gatlin, for helping me out with that.
Friggin' right I am.
It's always nice when you have friends, brother. Friggin' right it is. But don't forget to get over there and subscribe to the old Gatlin's channel there. I'll put it at the end of the video and in this description below. Why wouldn't I? But don't forget to subscribe and like, hit that thumbs up button for me. Why wouldn't you? And hopefully everybody's not doing anything like I'm not doing.
You know what to do for now.